You know, for a long time now, I've come to find myself falling in and out of trouble. I'm not sure why, I just do. Maybe it's in my nature, you know, genetics and all. Or maybe it was my upbringing. Although I don't know what could have caused it all, really. I mean, I was a happy child, great parents, a good home, and lots of friends. Maybe I'm a crazy person. Or maybe I'm just nasty.
I don't want to sit here and tell you my life story. No. What's the point in all that? Let's just go back a few days when things got weird. Lately, there had been this girl, or girls, I guess I should say, that I'd really had my eyes on. Real centerfold beauties, you know? Like the kind you read about in magazines. Good jobs, nice houses, smart too. Oh, and funny, the real take home to mom and show off to your friends type girl. Well, I've been kind of watching them. Keeping my eye on them, you know? To really find the girl for me. Well, I thought I found her. So that night, thought I'd go see her. I got ready, just like any other date. Nervous as hell, but excited, you know? I wanted to look good. I needed to feel good. I needed to be confident for her. I needed to be dapper, strong, charming, sharp. I wouldn't let anything stop me from seeing her that night. I was so nervous to see her. I could barely breathe. My stomach in knots, you know? I got there, a few minutes early, and waited. But like clockwork, there she was. Beautiful. Man, I mean, seriously, beautiful. Long hair, perfect skin. I wanted to get to know her, you know? I wanted her to know me. But like all good dates, they have to end. And so ours did. That night, I couldn't stop thinking about her. She was haunting my dreams. And of course, as things were getting good, business called. I had to meet a new client that night. I hate new clients.
Hey man, you got my stuff?
Yeah.
Come on man, let's go.
Here.
You serious?
Yeah.
VHS man, are you serious?
Yeah, VHS. What's wrong with that?
Yo, ain't nobody got a VHS player no more. You trying to screw me?
No, man, I'm not trying to screw you. Look, I'm just gonna go, alright? I think we had a misunderstanding here.
Misunderstanding? Yeah, we had a misunderstanding.
He took it all from me. My cameras. My life. And like that, he was gone. My body hurt so bad that night. And even with all the pain and anger I had, I could smile, you know? Because I still had her. I passed out that night, and maybe it was the pain, or maybe it was a fever dream. I don't know. But I swear to you, I saw my girl that night. I really did. I think that's when it all really kicked in. The realization that I almost lost her. And I think that fear, the fear that she could be taken from me at any moment, is what really scared me. I just couldn't lose her. I just couldn't. I just couldn't let her go. I had to see her. I needed to talk to her and tell her how beautiful she was. She needed to know. And there she was. She was reading. Like a smart girl. You know? I just wanted to love her. I could tell she saw me. Finally, she saw me. Our eyes met. My heart froze. I smiled at her, and all I could see was sheer terror.
Hey.
She looked at me like I was a monster. And right then, I could tell in her eyes that she didn't love me. She never did. I'm a monster.
I just wanted her to love me.
442. 42. Myself from 52 at 10-8. 10-4. Apartment directly across from her.